Hey y'all, Mary Kennedy here from Kennedy Fan 5. Let's look at some assessment tips for dilations. The first one would be for enlargement reduction isometry. This is what it looks like from the student point of view. This is a multiple choice grid on a Google form. I have to say, and it frustrates me, honestly, you're kind of limited to what you can put in here in the sense of it has to be something you can type. The fraction is not as pretty as I'd like it, but it's fine. It's fine here because this is a multiple choice problem. I can do an actual image for that answer choice, or I can use the equation editor, but you don't have that option when you're in the multiple choice grid, but it's still a really cool thing when it can be used for this. So I like it here because you're really just saying, okay, do you understand? I also like that you can make it so that they can't have the same answer for all three. I don't have that checked here on purpose because I mean, if they think all of those or enlargements, you know, I'd like to know that when I do the assessment. I do have that they have to have a response in every row because they need to answer each question. There it is, and you can't see it very well because of me. Limit to one response per column, and so I don't have that checked. The second thing I would say is to use color in your graphs. I think color is always helpful for sure, but I wanted them to be able to really distinguish, okay, if it's a red pre-image and it's going a dilation of 1.5, you know, they should be able to narrow it down from that. Okay, I would also say you can turn the question around where I show the graph and I say, you know, tell me what the dilation was. So it's instead of just giving a pre-image and saying dilate this by whatever, you know, you could show a pre-image and an image and work backwards. So this is a Google Forms mini assessment, and it is part of the transformations bundle that I have made. That's just 7 different assessments. I also have them state the coordinates, and I give them 2 different things as far as their givens. So here I'm giving them pre-image coordinates, and then here I'm giving them a graph, and they have to give me the image coordinates. You can click on any of those to hopefully give you some good ideas for how you might question your kids so that you can really assess that hopefully they're learning really well from you.